This is the Nokia 9 PureView, a device we've covered with an incredible degree of detail in so many rumors over the past few days. The return of the camera prowess from the company that created the need for this so many years ago. Reporting from New York City and Barcelona, I'm Jaime Rivera with Pocket Now. Let's go hands-on. I have to admit, I've been waiting for this day since the death of the Lumia 1020, the return of the Nokia that builds great cameras around phones to power them. They're calling this next-generation imaging for photography enthusiasts. Notice the term, photography. So let's begin talking about this camera system. We have five 12-megapixel cameras. Yes, five. 2 RGB, 3 monochrome, all at f1.8 aperture and Zeiss optics. Why? Well, remember the Lite L16 camera and how this company was more interested in licensing its software? Well, that's the company that's behind the genius in this technology. The first advantage is better dynamic range. Each monochrome sensor carries 2.9 times more light, which sums up to 10 times, all with different exposures. You also get a true monochrome mode, which I became a real fan of with Huawei phones. The second advantage is depth of field, as you get a full 12 megapixel depth map versus today's standard, which is nearly 10 times smaller. The service even supports G-Depth and Google Photos for you to be able to refocus your shots later. You can export raw photos in far more detail and have access to Adobe Lightroom to tweak them with some exclusive lens profiles made for this phone. The camera UI that we highly praise from Nokia returns with major pro camera updates, with better exposure controls, time-lapse photography, portraits, etc. It doesn't sound like it's quite the video camera though, as it only uses a single camera that's actually capable of 4K video at 30 frames per second, and we even hear that the selfie camera that's of 20 megapixels is also capable of 4K video at 30, though we're gonna have to confirm that. The next question is, how is this possible? Well, we have a Qualcomm Snapdragon 845 powering the show that's matched by a dedicated Lite Lux capacitor. This pushes heterogeneous computing architecture to its full potential. We're talking about the ISP, DSP, CPU, and GPU working in unison to process up to 240 megapixels of data. This would actually be the first ever phone to take full advantage of what the Qualcomm Snapdragon 845 could always do at 3 times more speed and 10 times more power efficiency. And sure, I know this is also a smartphone, let me actually tell you about that too. Spec-wise, we have 6GB of RAM, 128GB of non-expandable storage, a 3320mAh battery that supports wireless charging, improved acoustics on the microphones even if there's only a single firing speaker, and IP67 water and dust resistance. We have a gorgeous 5.99 inch Quad HD Plus P-OLED panel they're calling their Pure Display with some amazing and natural color reproduction and HDR10 support. There's even an optical on-display fingerprint scanner as well for biometrics. The phone is actually beautiful. Some well-thought-out design that reminds me of the sleekness of the Mate 10 Pro with some nice chamfered touches on the 6000 series aluminum. And best of all, this device runs Android 9 Pie 1 Edition, so there is no bloat. This is pure Google, and even in this pre-production unit that we saw, performance feels fantastic. So yes, this is the Nokia 9 PureView. I already told HMD that I cannot wait to test this phone. Sure, it might not follow the new approach of larger 48 megapixel cameras, but given Lite's reputation, I have a feeling this camera on such a beautiful device is going to be epic. What about you? Let us know what you think in the comments down below, and while you're at it, make sure you follow us on social media and subscribe to both our channels, English and Spanish, for more videos like this one. You can follow me on Twitter, Jaime_Rivera, or on Instagram at Jaime Rivera. Please give this video a thumbs up if you like what you saw. I'm Jaime Rivera. Thanks so much for watching. We'll see you on the next one.